I hope you have carefully studied our fourth video tutorial, because now you'll need all this knowledge. Today we'll animate cartoon men, and our little friend Kenny will help us in it. But where can we get this nice little Kenny? I remind you that all the materials for our video lessons can be found on our website General-Animation.com in the download directory. Once you have downloaded to your computer and unzipped the archive lesson 2 files, inside the resulting folder you will find another folder called Kenny. And in this folder... Oh my god! What a mess! What happened to our dear Kenny? Separately body, separately hands and even eyes. But do not worry, Kenny does not become a victim of a maniac killer. All these details we'll need for the animation. And so, I think you have already run the Adobe After Effects program. Let's create in the project panel a new folder and name it Kenny. Now let's export to this folder all components of Kenny. This is most easily done by dragging them with the mouse. Select all the parts of Kenny in Windows Explorer and drag and drop them directly into a folder Kenny. We'll also need the file background green to make a beautiful background. Drag and drop it on the same project panel. That's all, the import is finished. Now go to the animation. Let's create in our project a new composition of 1 minute duration. Drag and drop background on it. And now take all the parts of Kenny and throw them on top of the background. Check that all the layers on the timeline are placed right. The lowest should be background. Above it the Kenny's body, then pupils, and on the top arms. Well, all the parts lays in its places and we got our Kenny. Only one small problem. Right now all the parts are not connected to each other. If we, for example, move the Kenny's body, his hands and eyes will not move and remain in place. Just agree, it looks a little strange. Press Ctrl-Z to return the body on its place. For Kenny do not lost his hands and eyes, they should be tied to the body. This can be done by this little skein of threads on each layer. Grasp the thread by the mouse, pull to the layer to which we want to bind it, and release. Here in the little window, we at once see the name of the layer to which we are linked. Bind Kenny's eyes and hands to his body. Alright. Now, as we move the Kenny's body, his eyes and hands follow him as tied and obediently repeat all his movements. Now let's try to move his hands. Expand the list of options for the right hand and slightly change the rotation parameter. You can see that the hand began to rotate, but it simultaneously moves somewhere up or down. Return the rotation parameter to 0. In order to make hands to move in proper way, you should first to understand what the anchor point is. The anchor is the anchor. Therefore, anchor point is the point of fixation of the figure, the center around which performs all the conversions, including rotation, resizing, and various deformations. By default, the anchor point positioned exactly in the center of the figure. He is indicated by this small circle with a cross. This position of the anchor point not always suits us. For example, a hand should rotate around the shoulder, so the anchor point must be on the shoulder joint. To move the anchor point, you can use this tool, which is similar to the sighting frame. Click on it, and when you come back again on the picture, next to the mouse pointer will appear crosshairs, telling you that your pointer turned into a formidable weapon for repositioning of anchor point. Make sure that you have selected the layer with the right hand. Grip the anchor point by the mouse and drag it to the right Kenny's shoulder. Rotate the hand to make sure that everything moves as it should. Do the same with the left hand. Once you are done with the movement of anchor point, do not forget to click on the tool Simple Selection to return the pointer to its normal view. So now we know how to make Kenny wave his arms. Let me show you how to deal with files on the timeline. As you already know, any image that is placed on the timeline automatically extends the entire length of the timeline. But what if, for example, we have a dog that must to appear on the 20th second of our cartoon, and then on the 40th second to disappear again. Then we just grab by the mouse the beginning of the file with the dog and drag it to the 20th second mark on the timeline. Similarly, the end of the dog moves to the 40th second. Or you can drag the entire dog. Now our dog will magically appear on the 20th second of the cartoon, and on the 40th just as mysteriously vanish. Even easier, you can move files using the keys with brackets. Left curly bracket moves the files so that its beginning positioned on the current time indicator. And the right curly bracket moves to the current time indicator its end. If you want not just to move file, but cut it, Then use the brackets in the combination with the Alt key. Alt plus left bracket cuts beginning of the file, and Alt plus right cuts its end. Let's see all this in the practice. But first, I have to show you some useful features, which will help you to work quickly and efficiently. To access one of the parameters of the object, you got no need to open all properties of the layer. For quick access to the main parameters, are assigned keyboard shortcuts. For example, you need to change the parameter scale. Scale is S. Simply select the layer, the scale of which you want to adjust. Press the letter S on the keyboard, and the scale parameter appears before you in all its beauty. Rotation is R. Press R and get access to the parameter rotation. Position, as you may have guessed, is the letter P. But opacity is T. Each letter opens its parameter. But suppose you have already opened parameter position, and now want, in addition to it, open parameter scale. Then just press button shift and holding it down, press letter S. And see, the already opened parameter position adds parameter scale. Click with shift button R and you'll see edit rotation. Very useful is also U key, which opens all the animation for all selected layers. For fine detail work, you can enlarge the image simply turning the mouse wheel. If the picture crawled somewhere to the side, press and hold down the space bar, and the cursor will turn into a funny hand, with the help of which you can grab the picture and move it so that you can see the work area. When you again have to see the whole picture, drop down this listing in the down left corner of the viewer, and select the zoom fit up to 100. So here we have Kenny, and we want him to appear on the 3rd second of our cartoon. Holding shift down, select all the layers related to Kenny and drag them to the 3rd second mark on the timeline. Now Kenny will appear on the 3rd second. Let us make him appear not so abruptly, but somehow smoothly. This can be done very simply. Since we have all Kenny's parts tied to his body, it's enough to control only the body. Expand the list of options for the body. Move the current time indicator to the 1st second of composition. Turn animation for scale on. We immediately see the keyframe, which recorded that at this point the size of Kenny is 40%. Now go back to the 3rd second and set scale value to 0. Look and behold! From 3rd to 1st second, Kenny's size will increase from 0 to 40%, and the result is a smooth appearance of Kenny. It's time to introduce you to another important element of the After Effects interface. This is the work area bar. So we called a slider indicating the working area of our composition. It determines which part of the timeline will be rendered into the final video file. By default, the work area bar is extended to the entire timeline, but with the help of mouse, you can easily move its beginning and the end, or move the entire work area bar. You also can define the work area by using B and End keys. B is Begin. Clicking it, you'll set the beginning of work area. And N is the end. Pressing N key, you set the end of your cartoon. By the work area bar, you also can create previews. Select by work area bar little snippet that you want to view. This is usually no more than 10-15 seconds, depending on the amount of RAM in your computer. Press the space bar and wait for when the entire work area will turn green, which means that your computer created preview and placed it in the cache. Now you can watch the selected fragments without any breaks. To create the preview with the sound, press the 0 key on the numeric keypad.